Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.4.5 Developer Beta 2. Now, this is available to all developers, but at this time, or at least at the time of making this video, Apple has not released a public beta yet. Now, they may by the time you're watching this, and if they don't later today, expect it tomorrow. Apple did not release a public beta for the first version of this, so hopefully we see one for public beta testers. Now, this particular update came in at 191.2 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. I also have it installed on my iPhone XR, my iPad Air 2, and an iPhone 7. Now, Apple also released iPadOS 13.4.5 Beta 2, watchOS 6.2.5 Beta 2, as well as tvOS 13.4.5 Beta 2, and those are all available for developers right now to test out. Now, let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17F5044D, and this particular build really seems like it's more of a bug fix update. So it should be fixing issues that maybe we've seen with things like mail, where mail wasn't showing the proper number, and as far as what the email is coming in, and hopefully they've fixed some additional issues. In fact, there's no modem update, at least for the iPhone 11 Pro Max or on any other phones that I could see. However, I did see that someone mentioned that there might be a modem update for an iPhone 8. Like we have here. So it's hard to say. I haven't seen that myself, but some people may be seeing that. Now, within the notes, Apple did not mention anything as far as resolved issues or known issues, but they did mention the new feature where you can go into music and then you can share a story from your music to Instagram or Facebook. So if we go into the share sheet here, tap on Instagram, we can create a story automatically where it goes over to Instagram and then you can post it here. So it's a really nice feature, but there's not really anything new that we're seeing. Now, hopefully we're seeing some fixes as far as mail and things like that, but it's hard to say because that will take a few days to know that if this number is accurate or not. And the other good thing I've seen so far with this is I haven't seen any lockups in settings. I did see that with beta 1. So if I went into the settings and scrolled, things like that, it would lock up on me. I haven't been seeing that with this particular update. Now, as far as reception and everything like that, well, I haven't had any issues with beta 1, so I wouldn't expect, since the modem hasn't been updated, to see any issues with beta 2. I did check the storage as well because I figured there probably wasn't a whole lot new in this, but I wanted to see if storage has changed, and it hasn't changed at all from the previous version. So if you go to General, go to your iPhone storage, I do have more storage used here, but I do not have more system storage used. And that could be because I take more photos and things in between when I'm actually updating usually. So they'll update and backup from iCloud. So really, I haven't seen any differences with storage between the two betas. Still 7.55 gigabytes from the previous one, 4.49 gigabytes from other, and that's really it as far as that goes. However, other than the beta, Apple announced a couple new things today, which is really nice and something we've been looking forward to for a long time. And that has to do with the new iPhone SE. Now, I picked up the iPhone 7 because basically the new SE looks exactly like it, with the Apple logo moved to the middle, as you can see here. And what you get is a new iPhone that basically has the internals of the iPhone 11, but stuck inside the iPhone 8, minus that U1 chip for ultra wideband technology. It still has Wi-Fi 6, just like all the new phones. And the one downside might be is that it has a camera basically from the iPhone 8. However, it's using the Neural Engine and the A13 Bionic chipset to supposedly make the pictures a little bit better. It will have the same display and everything like that, as well as the Touch ID and haptic touch. It looks like 3D touch is no more. And in fact, Apple discontinued the 8 and 8 Plus today with 3D touch. So those phones are no longer being sold new from Apple. But the good thing is the new iPhone SE with its smaller screen comes in at $399 to start with 64 gigabytes. So it's a really good deal. So that's really nice. Now the iPhone SE will be available to pre-order this coming Friday and then should be shipped and delivered by the following Friday. So as soon as I can get my hands on one, of course, I'll have some videos on that. Now, Apple also made available to purchase their new keyboard or their Magic Keyboard for the iPad Pro. So I'll be wanting to check one of those out as well, and you can pick that up now, and that's pretty expensive. Now, they did also release some new cases for the iPhone SE. If you have an iPhone 7 or 8, the same cases will fit. They're interchangeable. So if you have the iPhone 8 with a bunch of cases, they'll work on the SE as well. Apple also released the availability of buying AirPods Pro replacement tips, and then also Mac Pro wheels. And the Mac Pro wheels are more expensive than an iPhone SE at $699. So if you want to change those yourself and you have a Mac Pro, you can put those on now. Now, as far as iPadOS, there's no new changes here as well. So you've got the exact same setup, just like you did before, no new features. Everything that's carried from iOS 13.4.5 is present here from beta 1 and beta 2. So nothing really new or exciting. But as far as the overall battery life, that will take a few days to measure. I know a lot of people want to know right away, but it really takes a couple days to cycle through the battery a couple times to give us an idea. But I can show you what it's been like on beta 1. So we'll take a look at battery health, and you'll see my battery health is at 99% after 6 months. And this is pretty normal. The updates do not affect the battery health. It just simply rechecks the battery health every time it updates. So it checks to see what the physical capacity is of the lithium ion battery. All phones have the same sort of setup. It just doesn't show it on all phones, only iPhones at this point. If we take a look at the last 10 days, you'll see it's pretty even as far as usage. So each day I used 3 to 4 hours of screen on time and hit about 50%. So that means that I'm getting about 8 hours of screen on time if I was to let the phone drain completely down. I'm also getting about 2 hours or so, or up to 4 hours if I let it drain, of screen off time as well. And you'll see most of my usage is social media and things like that. So it looks like I'm getting pretty consistent battery life each day with how I use it. One day I got 5 hours and 1 minute of screen on time. So I think it's pretty good. 10 to 12 hours is what I usually say. This one seems to be getting 8, but I haven't noticed that it was any lower than normal, except for one day. It did get down to 20%, but I was using it for FaceTime, so that will drain the battery a little bit quicker. Now, as far as performance on this beta, well, it's only been out a little bit, so everything seems good. Like I mentioned before, there's no lockups with scrolling or anything. And on older phones as well, one of the most requested devices that people ask me to show is the iPhone XR, and you'll find the same performance here as well, going into music, going into different applications. It's just super fast. I haven't seen any slowdowns. And then the next most requested phone to show is the iPhone 7, which this is actually the 7. So this is a 7 in jet black. I know a lot of people think it's the 8, but it's the 7. And again, super fast. No issues with this particular beta. Again, it will take a few days to know how it is when you load things. This is the first time opening music. You'll see it took a second to load, but it's scrolling smoothly. We should have good frame rates and things like that. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores. Now we'll go into Geekbench here, wherever I left it. There we go. We're using Geekbench 5. And I did have to run it a couple times on the 11 Pro Max just to see if I got consistent results. So for the single core, I scored 1,335. For multi-core, I scored 3,329. And let's take a look at the history and take a closer look. Now, the last time I ran Geekbench on this phone was on March 31st with the previous beta, and you'll see that the single core score is a little bit slower, but the multi-core score previously is a little bit faster. Now, again, these numbers can change over time as things are done in the background, but they're close enough that I really wouldn't worry about it, and so far nothing seems to be locking up, like settings or anything like that, like I mentioned before. Now let's take a look at Geekbench on all of these devices. Now on the left, we have the iPad Air 2, followed by the iPhone 7, then the iPhone XR, and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So if your scores are anywhere near these, this should give you a general idea that it's performing the same or better, or maybe a little bit worse, depending on what you have. Now, other than the bugs that I'm hopeful that Apple fixed, there's also mention of the iPhone SE in the code. We didn't know that it was called SE until later last week, but it looks like Apple has put this in the code since beta 1, and they mention a new iPhone with a home button or Touch ID, and that was the new iPhone SE. So it's neat that it's there, and we'll have that coming soon. So that's it for iOS 13.4.5 beta 2. Let me know if you found anything else in the comments below. It's not very exciting, but it may be out as soon as a couple Fridays from now, because the iPhone SE comes out on the 24th. So once we see the iPhone SE, it will need an updated OS that has the coding in it for it. So hopefully we'll see that on the 24th, or before that, maybe the Monday or Tuesday before that. And then maybe we'll see in between versions, or maybe Apple will just skip them altogether. Again, don't expect any major changes until WWDC is held online and they show off iOS 14. So we'll see all sorts of different features in that one. Now let me know what you think in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.